ongelooflijke eer om bij Petrus op het landgoed te staan. Duurste wijn ter wereld. Naast me staat Olivier Berouet. Thank you for your invitation. Can you introduce yourself a little bit?
Yes, if you want. So I'm the manager of the estate. And my main job is on the technical side of the estate. I have to manage the vineyard and also the vinification, the cellar, till the expedition of the wine, and sometimes also I show my face all around the world, very rarely.
Yeah. And especially today for us.
Exactly.
Okay. Let's go into the vineyard.
With pleasure.
Yes.
Let's go.
Okay. What is the typicity of this hill?
It's a great estate in Bordeaux. It's always linked to great soils. Yeah. I mean, you can't make great wine on average soils. And with the clay in Petrus, it's a little bit different because when the clay reaches its water capacity, all the water in excess will run at the top of the clay. So that's why the topography is very important,
yeah.
Because we're on a little hill, so it means when it's raining, the clay is becoming waterproof, yeah. When it reaches its water capacity, and all the water in excess will run at the surface of the soil.
Can you tell us a little bit about the vines and the grapes and the?
So for the moment it's green.
Yeah.
Because we're
make white
in July.
Wine?
Yes. We could with Merlot we could make white wine, but it would start to become black maybe around the 10th of August, and I think this year we probably will have a late harvest comparing to what we do regularly.
1 or 2 weeks.
I think we are two or three weeks late comparing to the other years. But for the moment, we think we will harvest at the end of September or just the start of October.
Okay.
In theory.
Yeah, in theory. Yeah.
But it never works.
No. And how many bottles do you produce from one vine?
60% of the vineyard is over 60 years old.
Yeah.
And so naturally we have a low production on those blocks.
Yeah.
So it means we produce half a bottle per vine.
If you, for example, harvest 3 days too late and your wine is of less quality, then the critics, they kill you. They say, this young guy, who does he think he is, and why did he?
I'm not. You know, when you make a decision, you're not alone. My father is still involved,
okay.
And the old cellar master also, and they are sharing their experience with me.
Yeah.
And we are less and less convinced by the fact that we need to be very careful in our techniques to do not go too far. And let the vines and the wine to express itself.
Yeah.
And I think the people that are making wines in the vineyard and in the cellar are very important because they are the end. But they don't have. They're here to help the wine.
Yeah.
They can't be too intrusive into the way of making wine.
The wine critics, the merchants. What about the pressure from them? You say, I can't change anything, but you're not your father.
Sorry, you?
You are not your father. You
no.
have different techniques.
Yes, but our approach of the wine is almost the same.
Okay.
I mean, the balance, the harmony, the lens, everything, the complexity are, for me, very important. And I think a great wine, whatever its price, it's a wine that has the capacity to tell the story of its land and its vintage.
Yeah.
And what makes, for me, one of the main difference between a good wine and a great wine is you have some wines that can be very impressive, that give you a big flash when you taste it as a first sight.
Yeah.
But what is important is the impressions that let.
Thank you. teruggekeerd in de kelders van Petrus. Olivier Berouet, natuurlijk een ongelooflijk druk bezet man, is inmiddels onderweg naar Bordeaux om andere dingen te doen. En wij mogen hier de 2012 versie, die nog in deze vaten achter mij is opgeslagen, mochten wij proeven, rechtstreeks uit het vat. Iets wat zelden tot nooit gebeurt. Ik kan een proefnotitie geven, maar ik denk dat het weinig zin heeft. Want dit is zo'n ongelooflijk grootse wijn. Die gaat zo ontzettend veranderen nog. Wat je nu al proeft is barstend vol met fruit. Een hele subtiele houtlagering erin. Fantastisch zachte tannines nu al. Je kan hem nu drinken, je kan hem over 20 jaar drinken, 50. Ongelooflijk mooi spul.